Hey everybody, I'm Miss Leah. I'm the children's librarian at the Hillcrest Library. We're going to be starting soon with our Explore with QPL back to school program. We're going to be talking about the Encyclopedia Britannica for elementary and middle school students. We're just going to give it a few more minutes for more people to join us. I'm so happy that you're all here with me. Did you guys know that September is Library Card Signup Month? You can let me know in the comments if you have a library card. You could raise your hand and say me. If you do, that's awesome. So see over here where it says my account. If you are not logged in, then it would say over there, get an e-card. So if you don't have a library card, you could get an e-card right there. An e-card, Queens Public Library card is free for anyone who lives, works, attends school, or owns property in New York State. So if you don't have one yet, you can get one today. It's free. So again, this is part of like a series that we have. It's the Back to School Explore with QPL series. So every Tuesday at 5 p.m., we're going to be talking about a different resource that the library has to help students. So we got, last week we had Miss Ashley discuss the Power Knowledge database. That's for science. In the coming weeks, we're going to be doing other databases, like we have BrainFuse, which offers live tutoring and homework help. We have a bunch of other World Book, a lot of other good resources. So just stay tuned Tuesdays at 5 p.m. on the library's Facebook page. Okay, I think I'm going to get started a little bit. Again, welcome to Queens Public Library. This is Explore with QPL Back to School series. I'm Miss Leah from Hillcrest. Right now, Queens Public Library is open for to-go service at certain locations. That means that you can pick up materials that you requested and you can return materials. That's what's going on right now. You could read more details at queenslibrary.org, which is what we're looking at right now. Like I mentioned, it's library card sign-up month, back to school time. So for tips on helping your child adjust to wearing a mask or resources at the library, or health tips and more, you can visit our blog. And if you're interested in finding other virtual Queens Public Library programs or accessing our digital materials, including information on how to get an e-card and how to be counted in this year's census, or to make a donation to the library, visit queenslibrary.org. That's queenslibrary.org. And really important about the census, without an accurate count of children, your community is going to have fewer resources for children, including libraries, hospitals, schools. So please make sure that your children and babies are counted by September 30th. That's the deadline. It's really close. And only about half of New York City's children have been counted so far. So don't be left out. To fill out the census, you can go to my2020census.gov. Again, that's my2020census.gov. Or you can call them at 844-330-2020. Right. So again, I'm Miss Leah. Miss Sarah is going to be helping me out with the Facebook comments. There's a lot to cover and we're going to be moving fast, but don't worry if you miss something, it's all going to be recorded and it's all going to be on the library's Facebook page afterwards. Okay. So right now we're looking at the Queens Library website. So this is queenslibrary.org. So it might look different if you are viewing it on a tablet or on a phone. So you might have the menu on the side over here in the corner. So like, for example, like that, this is what it would look like in that case. So in that case, you could choose the research from over here. But if you're looking at it from a larger computer screen, then you could choose research from over here. And we're going to go to research databases. Just hang on while it loads. So the research databases page is a listing of all the resources that the Queens Library subscribes to that you have access to as a member of the library. So it's an alphabetical listing. You could, you know, select different categories if you want to, or you could just scroll down. The one that we're looking at today is Encyclopedia Britannica. There are a lot of different types of Britannica. You could say academic, elementary, escolar, which is Spanish. We're gonna right now click on Britannica School. And that's gonna show us all the different Britannica resources for elementary, middle, and high school. So this is what I call the tree page. So elementary school, I would say, is for like up to maybe fourth or fifth grade. And then middle is for middle school students, and high school is for high school students. We're going to be starting with elementary, but there's a lot of similarities across the board. So even if you're really waiting to hear more about the middle school stuff, stay tuned, just pay attention, hang in there. We're going to be looking at elementary first. This is the homepage for the elementary school website. So they always have a challenge up here. So it says, name the image. So I want you guys, this is a challenge for you. You guys can put into the comments, what do you think is the answer? What should I click over here? Type in the comments what you think. The question is, this horn is played on the Jewish holidays of Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur. What is it called? And options here are shofar, tishrei, golden calf, and kudu. Rosh Hashanah is actually coming up really soon. I think it's this Friday night. So if you guys have any thoughts on what the answer might be to this question, they have a few different questions they usually ask, and it changes every few days. Anyone have a vote? Okay, we're going to choose shofar. Yes, you got it right. Awesome. Okay, so let's just look around this page. Besides for this challenge question over here, there's also, it says Britannica School over here. So if I click on this, Britannica School, that will bring me back to that tree page that we were just on with the elementary, middle, high choices. And if I click on elementary, that brings me back to this homepage. So we're going to use that soon to come back here without having to click the back button on the browser too much. The search bar is, you know, how search bars work. Type in what you want to find. And this option to sign in over here, it's not necessary, but it could be useful if you do use the Encyclopedia Britannica often. It's something that you could use to like save your favorites, like your favorite articles or media, like pictures or videos, whatever you want to use. So optional, but might be helpful to you if you use it a lot. And we're going to take a look now at this box with different clouds over here. So a few options. First is this articles. So this is going to give you just the articles. I mean, just the text. That means that it's not the pictures or videos or any of those extra things. So this is just different topics. And within these topics, if you click on it, then you're going to see a listing of different subjects within that topic. And you could choose whatever you want. And there's just going to be different entries, like the way that encyclopedia would work. And you could choose whatever you want to take a look at, whatever strikes your fancy. And if you just choose media over here, that's the opposite of articles. So again, that's going to be just the pictures and just the videos. So it's not going to have any articles at all. So this is really helpful if, let's say, you have a assignment for school and you need to gather some pictures, or you need to make some sort of like video or something, then this is a really good resource to get those pictures. But you're going to want to make sure that you cite your sources. So if you decide to use one of these pictures, then a really easy way to cite your source is to click on this little checkbox over here, and you can copy the citation over here, which basically means that you took the picture with permission, which is a really important thing to do. Okay, so we're going to go back to elementary over there. Okay, we're going to keep looking at these clouds over here. So World Atlas, that means it's like a map of the world. And you can either click on the map to learn about a different location, whatever you want to do some research about, or you could search over here where it says find a place. So let's say I'm interested in New York. So if I want to find out more information about New York, besides for just looking at the map, I could click over here where it says summary, and that starts off the article that would be in the encyclopedia. You could read the article if you want. There's also this profile over here that gives you basic statistics and information about the state, stuff like, you know, the population, or, you know, when it joined the union. And there's also related, which shows you other topics related to New York, but it's usually the people that live there. So that is World Atlas. So we're gonna go back to elementary homepage. And after World Atlas is biographies. So this is really helpful. If let's say you have an assignment to do some research on some person, but you don't have anyone specific in mind, or if you do want to find someone, but you want to just kind of browse around and see more. So if you don't want to just search it right there in the search bar, you could click on the letter. So let's say I want to do B, and I'm going to look for someone interesting in B. Clara Barton, that looks interesting. Clara Barton was a nurse during the Civil War. So this gives me the article about her. And we're gonna talk more about what's in the article later on. That's how you use the biography tool. Okay, Animal Kingdom, which is specifically just about animals. And they have by group or by habitat. They're both pretty cool options. So I'm gonna give you guys a choice right now. Please vote in the comments if you've got an opinion on this. Should we research penguins or camels? And I wanna hear what you have to say. Should we do penguins or camels? So if you would do penguins, probably you would choose like birds and then see what they've got underneath there. Camels, I think, would be under mammals over here. If you wanted to explore by habitat, then probably deserts would be good for camels. And probably polar or tundra regions would be good for penguins. Okay, let's see if you got any comments yet. Oh, it looks like all the votes are for penguins. Okay, so let's do penguins by clicking on birds. And flightless birds. Because I know penguins don't fly, and they even have a picture of penguins over there. So that's a really easy way to know. Here's penguin. Yay, penguins are really cute. So they've got the picture here, and they've got the article over here. And again, we're gonna talk more about the layout of this page soon. Okay, we're gonna go back to elementary home. So that was the Animal Kingdom. This fundamentals over here, it's a really good resource for kindergarten through second grade students. It's like a very simple version of Encyclopedia Britannica. It's a great resource, but we're not going to look at it today. Tour of the USA is helpful if you just want to, it's kind of like the World Atlas, but it's just specifically for America. So if you wanted to find out more about a specific state, you could just click on it and see more information about that state. And this is the Geography Explorer. So that's gonna actually, it's gonna be like a little map building game kind of. And this last part over here is compare countries. So that's helpful if you want to compare two different countries, you could choose which country and then it will have like kind of two columns giving you different information. And you could easily compare the statistics between two countries. Like let's say if you want to know which of these two countries have a more population or something. Okay. So that was all the clouds in the box over here. So now we're going to try it out. And I want you guys to vote in the comments, please. Do you want to research volcanoes or space shuttles? Those are two really interesting topics. We're going to use the search bar over here to research those. So again, it's volcanoes or space shuttles. If you've got an opinion on that, then let us know in the comments. Volcanoes are pretty cool. They're kind of scary though. Space shuttles are cool. I like outer space. They're both good choices. But you guys get to choose. Which one are we going to do some research about? Okay, let's see if you got any votes. Oh, so far I see you've got votes about volcanoes. It looks like everyone wants volcanoes. Okay, so let's research volcanoes. Ready? So I typed it in. And here's the results page. So they have, this is kind of the opposite of when you Google something. Usually when you Google something, like the very first result is like an ad or something, and then it's not really what you want. But in this case, the first thing that pops up is actually the thing that you want. It's the volcano geology that you're talking about. And they do have also, if you wanted to specifically look for images or videos or something like that on the side, then you could do that. But we're going to look at the article, and it's going to have the images also on the side of the article. So here is some information about volcanoes. Oh, they even have a video here. That's cool. We're not going to play it right now because I don't know how that's going to come out with the sound and whatever over the streaming service. But we have here an introduction about volcanoes, and it talks about eruptions and the magma and all the stuff that comes out of it, where volcanoes form, how that works, the ring of fire, that's cool. Volcanic landforms. So they have like little bites of information here. So that's helpful. It's not like you're looking at like a huge screen full of text. I have all this information about volcanoes. There's a lot to know. Different information about the history of volcanoes. Okay, so we're going to just talk about what we see over here. Besides for the text of the article, the information, there is, of course, the media here on the side. So there's pictures, videos. You could scroll through. We've got different things. If you want to take a closer look at anything, you can. This is like a little, the kind of thing you would see in an encyclopedia, different images that show you how volcanoes work. And on the side here, so you've got that star. That's if you want to make it into your favorite. Again, like I mentioned in the beginning, if you want to sign in, you could see favorites, but otherwise, I don't think it works. To print the article, you would press over here. One thing to make note of, though, if you want to print out the article, it's just going to give you the text. So it doesn't automatically include the pictures. So that's just something to be aware of. It'll just be the text on the page. You could email it if you want. You can cite it. Like I mentioned earlier, it's really important to cite your sources. So like, let's say you wrote a book and then somebody wrote a book report on the book and they didn't even say that you were the author of the book. That would really probably not make you feel very good. So it's really important to say where you got your information from to give credit to the people that put together that information. And also so that, let's say, like your teacher wants to know that you didn't make that up. Like, let's say she doesn't believe you about the Ring of Fire. So if you have a citation and she knows, oh, it came from the Encyclopedia Britannica, that sounds reliable. So then you could have that citation. You could also increase the font, which is helpful, especially for younger students. And you can translate the page if you want. Okay, so the next thing that we're going to look at is that you can upgrade your reading level. So you see it's got article reading level 1 over here. That's what we're on right now. If I click 2, that's going to bring me to the middle school version of this same article. Another way I could go to the middle school is to go back to Britannica School. That will bring us to the tree page and then click on middle. But an easy way to transfer would be just to click on the 2. I'm just going to double check that you don't have any questions yet. Okay, so now we could see that we are on the middle school page of the volcano article. So wow, they have a really cool picture here. I like that one. Check that out. So the middle school page is pretty similar in a lot of ways to the elementary school page. Most of the features are pretty much the same. We've got, you know, the search bar on the top. You have media along the side over here. And you could also look at the media separately if you wanted to by clicking over there. Not sure what that was. there is a lot more information about like a lot more different topics. So there's more mature topics like war, for example, that wouldn't be in the elementary version. So that's just something to be aware of if you, as a parents out there, if you wanted to make sure that your students are getting their the information that's appropriate for them. There's more mature topics, and there's more information on just a broader range of topics. So within this page, you've got the same favorite, print, cite, translate. You could also listen to have it read out loud to you, make the fonts bigger or smaller. And they've got all kinds of different websites, articles, different things that you can consult if you're doing a research paper. So I'm going to click on middle to bring me back to the homepage for the middle school website. And they have pretty similar to the elementary website. They've got like different questions, but over here, it's not like you select the answer. It's just like they ask you a question and then you could click on it to learn more. And then you could find out the answer by reading the article. So besides for articles, images and videos, biographies, world atlas, compare countries, all that stuff that we saw in that box of clouds on the elementary page, there's a few more things. For example, they have this primary sources, which is great because sometimes teachers ask you specifically to cite primary sources when you're doing a research project. So they actually have here the text of different primary sources, like the Declaration of Independence. That's an important one. So that's a really good section over there. They also have this section called New and Revised Articles, which is kind of cool to see. A lot of it has to do with recent events. And it's cool to see also that they actually like update these things pretty regularly. So you're sure that this is a really reliable resource because they make sure that it doesn't go out of date. Okay. So I'm going to invite you once again. Of course, if you've got any questions, let me know. But I'm going to invite you once again to take a vote on which topic we should research on the middle school page. Do you want to research unicorns or car racing? Again, it's unicorns or car racing. So we're going to search. Believe it or not, they do have encyclopedia articles about both of those. Unicorns, the mythological creatures, or automobile racing. So let me know in the comments what you think we should take a look at today. Which one should we do some research about? Okay, I see so far you've got a vote for unicorns. Another vote for unicorns, wow. Okay, maybe we'll research unicorns then in that case. Sorry for all the car racing fans out there. Okay, so they've got first result is unicorn, mythological creature. That's probably what we want. That's a legendary animal, and the unicorn would be one of the subsections under there. So we're just going to click on that first result, unicorn. And that's an interesting picture of a unicorn there. The Lady and the Unicorn, that's the title of it. Interesting. So you'll notice, by the way, that they've got three different reading levels here. So on the elementary school page, there was the option of reading level one, which was the one that you were looking at, or if you clicked two, that would bring you to middle school. So all of these are within the middle school range. So if you click one, it's still middle school. It's just like a little bit easier, but it's still going to keep you on the middle school website. And if you click three, it's going to give you a little bit of a longer article with maybe more pictures, which is an important thing to keep note of, actually, that they have different media for different levels of the articles. So if you've got like the easier ones will generally have fewer pictures and videos to go along with them than the more complicated ones. Alrighty, does anyone have any questions? I would be so happy to answer them. And again, this is that was elementary and middle that we looked at. If you wanted to look at the high school also, that's, you can just go back to Britannica School and look at that over there. And all these resources are free through the Queen's Library website, queenslibrary.org, then research, then research databases, and choose Britannica, whichever one you wanted. Okay, so I think we'll wrap up if nobody has any questions. I'm so happy that you all joined us today, and happy researching. Thank you for joining us, and please continue to check our Facebook page for more live programs. Again, this is recurring weekly on Tuesdays at 5 p.m. We have this program that we're showcasing different resources. And we also have recordings of all the past programs on our Facebook page, including this one. So you can watch it again if you weren't sure about anything. So stay safe and have a great night.